Oh, all right, TV for sale.
Yeah, it's for sale.
Yeah, how much?
$1.
Only a dollar?
Just $1.
How come it's so cheap?
Oh, because the volume's turned all the way up. You can't adjust it, stuff that way.
So the volume's turned all the way up?
Yep.
And it's only a dollar?
Just $1.
Because the volume's turned all the way up.
Yep.
Wow, can't turn that down.
WCVH proudly presents CV Today.
Good afternoon. Today is Tuesday, February 13th.
Now we're to Mr. Fox with some more announcements.
Hello, CV. It's Mr. Fox here to announce January's Students of the Month. These students have excelled inside and outside the classroom, and we want to commend them for their hard work. The following students are asked to report to the main office for fifth block to have their picture taken for our display outside the main office. The following students are our January Students of the Month: Ryan Graham, Dylan Immler, Eddie Torres, John V. Patel, Carly Roush, Lance Rich, Sheryl Medina, and Shannon Rainier. Congratulations to all these students.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, always try to maintain complete tolerance and always make an effort to give people more than they expect, by Scott Hamilton. Today's lunch is 4 meat pizza and the hot combo is rib sandwich. Tomorrow's lunch is French toast sticks and the hot combo is grilled chicken sandwich. Now over to your weather report.
It could be a day for a sweater or wind stronger than leather. For all your daily news, here's Matt with the weather.
Welcome back to the Nature Life documentary. Over there, we have a wild panda. Do you see it? I'm gonna catch it, and I'm gonna ride it. Let's go.
Come here, panda.
It's currently 25 degrees out here in Lancaster County. With a high of 35 and a low of 24. As you can see, right now it's extremely sunny, but expect cloudy skies in the later part of the afternoon. Now we're to headline news.
It was a devastating incident involving one of Las Vegas's most popular tourist activities, helicopter flights to the Grand Canyon. According to authorities, the crash happened near the West Rim. Three passengers died at the scene, and four others were airlifted in critical condition.
Probably not, no matter how much people say they're safe.
Tourist reaction only 2 days later is mixed, but mostly hesitant.
I don't think I want to do that anymore.
Some telling us they would likely pass on an opportunity to take the flight if it were offered now.
I've flown the EC-130 and like it a great deal. It has a very good payload in it. And the aircraft has a very, very good record.
News 3 aviation expert Reed Yadon, however, says the aircraft itself is reputable. In fact, several local tour companies fly the same helicopter to and from the Grand Canyon. Those investigating Saturday's crash will search a number of areas to determine what went wrong. Everything from the weather to the mechanics, as well as the pilot.
Go back and look at training records on the pilot. Go back and look at maintenance records on the aircraft. Go back and look at flight records.
One thing they won't have for review is a flight recorder, sometimes referred to as a black box, as they are not required on aircrafts of this size. Industry insiders say more than 500,000 tourists fly to the Grand Canyon every year, which proves it's safe. The risk, however, is always present.
Dickies is hiring for after school and weekends. Good pay, flexible hours, no late nights, age 16 and over. We schedule around your schedule. Convenient location at 2481 Lincoln Highway East, across from Rockvale Outlets. Call 717-435-8444 or email dickieslancaster@gmail.com or stop by the restaurant, ask for Chip or Scott. Attention students. Learning Lab will be held on Thursday, February 15th, but there will be no transportation home for students. Now over to announcement about Black History Month.
February is Black History Month. But why? Where did Black History Month come from? It began with this man, Carter G. Woodson, a historian and writer. Woodson noticed that his people were, quote, overlooked, ignored, and even suppressed by the writers of history textbooks and the teachers who use them, end quote. So he started a Black History Week in 1926. And people celebrated it enthusiastically. They started Black History Clubs, and teachers started recognizing the contributions of Black Americans in their classrooms. He chose February, by the way, because it held the birthdays of both Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass, two men he believed had done tremendous work for the rights and liberties of African Americans. It took another 50 years, though, for Black History Month to become officially recognized by our government. The president at the time, Gerald Ford, said that we should seize the opportunity to honor the two often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. Here's the funny thing, though. Carter G. Woodson hoped that someday people would no longer celebrate Black History Month. He saw the day when it would no longer be necessary, when finally we would see Black history in America for what it really is, an essential part of American history.
Seniors, the 2018 PAMS Annual Julie Sullivan Memorial Scholarship is now available in the Guidance Office. The purpose of this scholarship is to recognize outstanding students who have been successful in their educational pursuits while overcoming physical challenges with the help of home medical equipment and supplies. The scholarship deadline is March 23rd. Hands-On House is looking for summer volunteers. Volunteering for summer camp involves one entire week, Monday through Friday, in the morning. If you are interested, please stop in the Guidance Office for the volunteer interest form. Now over to the word of the day.
Word of the day today is banal. Commonplace or boring?
Tegan, look at my new shoes.
What shoes?
Seriously, that joke is so banal. It's so overused.
Seniors, the following three scholarships are available. The Katherine Oster Scholarship is now available in the Guidance Office. To be eligible for this scholarship, you must be accepted for admission in a fully accredited college, university, or vocational school located at anywhere in the United States. The scholarship deadline is April 15th. The Joseph F. Kurjawaka Scholarship is now available in the Guidance Office. This scholarship is eligible for a student who is applying and will be attending at a campus for the Pennsylvania State University majoring in business administration or education for the 2018-19 academic year. The scholarship deadline is March 30th. The Holoran Education Scholarship is now available in the Guidance Office. This scholarship is eligible for a student who is accepted into a four-year accredited college and achieves a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or better during high school. This student also has had to demonstrated school and or community services involving promotion of multiculturalism during the first 3 years of high school. The scholarship deadline is March 31st. Now over to CB Sports.
Yeah. Ride with the mob. Alhamdulillah, check in with me and do your job. Ferg is the name, Pinballer did the chain, Tono for the watch, Prezi plain Jane. Yamagini chain, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes Linka feed a village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures causing my hysteria. Mama see me on BT.
The boys' tennis team meeting is going to be held on 2-15 at 3 o'clock in the health room.
Attention, boys interested in playing volleyball this spring. Boys volleyball sign-up sheets as well as an open gym schedule outside of the athletic office for anyone that wants to sign up is available.
We have no sports for you today.
Now over to sports highlights.
Simmons, and that time, pretty good defensive player, and Lance Thomas did a little cheating.
Speaking of lulls to sleep, Beasley trying to keep the Knicks from being lulled to sleep here.
Finds Courtney Lee, who nails the three-pointer. Lead is now a dozen. Tim Hardaway kicks it out. Courtney Lee, that's his second three-pointer from that same spot.
3, 2, 1!
Has a Turkish passport, at least. We think he still has it as Simmons compliments it T.J. McConnell. Blocked by Beasley. Right on cue. Some nice defense from Beasley. Jarrett Jack to Hardaway. Chased off the three.
That play kills the purists.
Beasley gets inside. Right-handed lays it in. And a timeout call by McConnell, the swipe. He's got company. It's Covington. And he throws it down in the face of Beasley. And if they win here tonight, they'll be looking to sweep the homestand that evening. Simmons all the way in, and he flushes two more.
That's all the announcements we have for you today. On behalf of WCVH, I'm Mr. Shank.
Alongside Megan Stone, and this is CV Today.
Have a Chloe Kim crushing it on the half pipe for America Tuesday.